Welcome to LanePoisRC. My name is Werner. Today I want to show you a video of how to build the light controller circuit boards on surface mount components using the PCB. I recently built a few, so I thought I'd make a video. So here I'm taking out the solder paste. You can get these jars on eBay for $5 from China. Solder paste has a lifetime of about half a year apparently. But this one is more than 1 year old already and still seems to be working fine. We keep it stored in the fridge when it's not in use. I'm spreading it onto a plastic card that I received from Osh Stencils. The stencil is the yellow foil that you can see on the circuit board, which has laser cut holes built in at the locations where the solder paste needs to go onto the surface on the PCB. So already, so it's time to, like a silk screen process, put on the solder paste. Not too much pressure, not too little pressure. The angle not too steep, but also not too flat. So gently moving it over, and we are done. Checking everything, looks fine. So we can flip up the stencil. And here you can see the solder paste dark gray at all the positions where the pins of the chips go. So we take it out of the jig. This is just some scrap PCBs to make a frame in the same height as the circuit board. And we can put in the next board. Make sure it's aligned properly in the right orientation. Flip back the stencil. And try again. This time I'm having the spreader in a too shallow angle, and that causes too much solder paste to go on, which has the effect that you get solder bridges, so short circuits later. So time for placement of the components. We start with the biggest components, the light controller chip. Put it into position and then gently nudge it with the tweezers until all the pins line up. The pins are only 0.65 millimeters apart, so it's a little bit of a fiddly job, but just be patient and take your time, relax, then everyone can do it. Before putting on the second chip, I'm putting on the tiny bypass capacitor that goes between them, because if I would do it later, I most likely would nudge the ICs out of place. So I just changed my mind here. I'm not putting on another capacitor, but rather continue with the microcontroller. This is the same pin pitch, but a smaller package. I'm checking where the pin 1 is to make sure the orientation is correct. Put it down. It's flipped off a little bit, so I have to nudge it back. The solder paste is a bit tacky, so it kind of sticks down the components a little bit. So almost all the components are done, just a few resistors left. Again, nudge them gently into place and then gently tap them down into the solder paste to make sure they are secure and firm. The circuit boards come from a company called Smart Prototyping in Hong Kong / Shenzhen. 10 boards cost about $10 plus another 5 for shipping, up to 5 times 5 centimeters in size. So the light controllers are 27 millimeter by 18. So that's a very reasonable cost, and the boards arrive usually within 2 weeks. And they are really a fantastic quality. I so far haven't seen a single board out of at least 100 boards. So I'm very happy with the quality and the price and the service. So I'm using here a magnifying lens, a 5x lens, to just check everything again if everything is aligned. Actually, off camera, I use this magnifier to even place the components because it's just easier for me to see. We are now done with the placement. It's ready for soldering. So I'm putting them on a scrap prototyping board just to ensure that nothing gets toasted. And I'm using a hot air reflow soldering station. Again, eBay, $80 shipped. Very useful tool, has a blower in the handle and a heater. It's also useful for heat shrink or for applying RC decals, of course at a lower heat. So we're starting heating up the board slowly, quite a far away, and the more hot it gets, we get closer and closer to the components until the solder melts. And this is actually very easy to see because the solder turns from this darkish gray into a shiny bright silver. And that's the point where you're actually really soldering, and that's called the reflow process. It takes 2 minutes to do that. We are more than halfway through now, so very soon you will start seeing parts of the circuit board get shiny when the soldering happens. I'm already quite close to the board now with the nozzle. We can already see the first solder pads being shiny if you look carefully. Now more and more pads get shiny. Almost done now. Going back and forth just to make sure that everything is properly reflowed. And that's it, we are done. Same process again in a more close-up. So again we start higher up. Heat the board up gently and the components up gently that they don't get damaged. And as the board warms up, we go closer with the nozzle, and in about 2 minutes time we see the reflow process. So now the nozzle is already quite close to the board. We are more than halfway through, and very soon we will start. We see already the flux going on, and now the solder is melting. Again going over everywhere, all the solder joints have now melted. I'm making sure that they're all hot, and you can also see at the big IC on the left side, you can see two places where two pins have been joined with a solder bridge, so we're gonna have to fix that. So to do that is we apply some flux. Here I'm using a flux pen, again eBay special for a few dollars. You can never have enough flux. Take the soldering iron, heat it up, and drag it out. Again, and done. The solder is just whipped away with the soldering iron and the flux. So 3.5 hours later we have 20 boards ready. All put the solder paste on, components placed, and reflowed. So we put on the connector. I put a little bit of flux on. You can never have enough flux, even though there's flux in the tin that I'm using. I'm tinning one of the pads, and I'm holding the connector on the other end to not burn myself. Putting it on and tacking it down. And then I'm starting on the other end to go pin by pin and solder them down. It doesn't work so well, the iron is not hot enough, so I'm turning up the heat a little bit. And that works much better. Now we can go from pin to pin. 1 second per pin and we are done. I'm also doing the one that I have tacked down initially, just to make sure it's flow properly and looks nice and clean. Alright, all done, time for testing and programming. So I'm using my small netbook computer, and I have a USB to serial dongle that can be used to flash the firmware into this microcontroller. I made a custom programming cable to line up all the pins easily. Plug it in. Push the programming button on programming software, and error. Most likely the microcontroller was plugged in improperly first time, second time works fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, done. Everything is programmed. Time for testing. I'm still using the USB to serial dongle just to provide me with the 5 volts from USB. It's convenient to get power, so I don't need an extra battery or a PC or something. And I'm also hooking up an LED via this clip here to plus 5 volts to test all the light outputs. So plug in the ground, plug in the plus 5 volts and test all the light outputs. They should blink because we flashed the blink program. There we go. So that it's off, dark, bright, and then it's off, bright, dark alternately. So I can easily see if there would be a problem with two short circuit light outputs. I'm going from pin to pin, checking them. All looks fine so far. Few more to go. And all ready. So that's a built light controller. I also made two other circuit boards that act like a case, so there's a frame in between that goes around the components, just the same thickness, 1.2 millimeter as the components, and the another circuit board which is just empty on top to close it all up. A little bit of epoxy and it's all nicely sealed and can be stuck into a C-car. I used some alcohol and acetone mix to clean up all the flux residue. And as you can see on this close-up shot, it looks really nice and very professional. So thank you for watching. I hope it's inspired you to also start a little bit on RC electronics. We need more RC people that make RC electronics to get great products out there. Have fun!